Hello, hello, and welcome to another update video about Ethereum. Exciting today, not too much happened, but we had a little bit of movement, which is always good to see, especially if it's to the upside. If you remember from previous videos, we've been waiting for some kind of a signal out of this yellow support area that we could rally in our third wave that we're actually waiting for into the $2,400, $2,500 region. I did want price to get into this region between 1780 and 1830. That's where we arrived. You can't really get it better and more precise because at some point you get to, when you go too micro, you know, the waves are too small and the degree is too small. You don't get more wisdom. You don't get more clarity. So I think it landed exactly in that region where I wanted it. Would have been nice to come down to 1780. Maybe it will still do that. But it was good enough in my opinion, yeah? So we came basically into the middle of our trend reversal area. If it turns around here, it would be okay. I would be more happy with Ethereum going up from that structure than Bitcoin. I already shared that on Discord and Telegram that if Ethereum goes up from here, I wouldn't want to see that much proof as on the Bitcoin chart. The reason for that I explained on the Bitcoin in the Bitcoin video. Ethereum has a sufficient bottoming structure, not perfect, but good enough. And the move up can be counted as an impulse if it's holding 1850. And that's also the level that I would consider a failure. If price now breaks below 1850, we talk about that in a minute. Bigger picture wise, never forget sight of the bigger picture. We had a wave one to the upside into the July highs and a wave two to the downside, which could still be ongoing. Basically quite neutral between, okay, is this a B wave up or already the breakout? So we will see. Market needs to show it, of course, but essentially the yellow area is the area where we expect to turn around. So I tell you what we need to see to make that bullish wave count, the more direct bullish breakout, more likely. Don't forget that our bullish support is at $1,700. So the idea is that as long as we stay above that level, this particular wave count where we expect higher into the $2,400, $2,500 region remains the expectation. So in the short term, yeah, we now can potentially count this correction complete. So the yellow wave count shows what we need to see. In the white wave count, that's the count we had on the chart before, nothing happened. We didn't get invalidation, even though it's very close, but it didn't break above 1867. Only briefly, but not a sustained break. So actually, the situation hasn't changed on the ETH chart. However, of course, very extreme in this scenario, and therefore it forces me sort of to put that direct bullish breakout count onto the chart. So what do we need to see now to confirm that we are indeed moving up and that we are in the third wave rally? I think a good confirmation would be, first of all, to put in place the five waves that you can see here on the chart. So we've got more already on the 1 minute chart, 1 hour chart. So we've got a small 1-2 down here, a third wave potentially with this swing high that was made today at 1876. This could be a fourth wave, and one more wave would be needed to the upside, and then I have a five wave move up. The third wave reached what it needed to reach. It reached a 1.618 extension level. Yeah, which is what it needs. So now I'm watching if the wave four holds support. What is support? Support is 1850. It's the 50% Fibonacci retracement here. Yeah, this level now needs to hold. A wave four that goes below the 50% Fib level, not reliable. So that's the level I wanna see. I will consider it a failure below 1850. It can then still develop as a diagonal, but it would again be less reliable. So at the moment, if it's going to be an impulse, it needs to hold 1850. This is probably the fourth wave, and it needs to hold that level. Then we could get one more high to round about $1,900, maybe a little higher. That would be perfect. Would I tell you then it has already bottomed? No, I would need to see three waves down, but if it's holding that, then probably A, B, C. So five waves up, I could consider that a wave one then, and then an A, B, C structure down in a wave two, and we could consider it has bottomed if it comes back in a three wave move then. Basically, we now only get a micro trade setup for higher. If we get five waves up, then we can calculate three waves down. Until then, the white wave count, of course, is still likely with one more wave down here. But I told you exactly the level that I would consider a failure. And we talk about a sustained break below 1850. I mean, if it goes for a couple of minutes below 1850, not a problem, right? But yeah, that's the situation here on the ETH chart. And that's also why I'm more happy to call Ethereum potentially as bottom than Bitcoin, even though in reality they will probably move together. But Ethereum, I don't need that much proof because it has a better structure in this correction than Bitcoin, a clearer structure. Yeah, that's my update about Ethereum. I hope you liked the update. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment and subscribe. And if you really like the content, then please check out the channel membership. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.